Working in customer support is never easy. Working in tech support, I can't even imagine. Welcome to this episode of Tales from Tech Support. Our first tale is from Insane Peach, titled, Yes, It Is Related. A sales guy with an alphabet soup of Microsoft cert letters after his name and his signature line submits a ticket because his email has quit working. He can open Outlook, but can't send or receive anything. This was before cloud, so we asked them to bring the laptop in, since the Exchange server and account looked fine. While we add the laptop, first step is to start the process to update and patch, because we don't expect SGs will ever do that on their own, and the update or reboot may fix the issue. Laptop, disk space is full. Checking the hard drive, it was 100% full, more like 101% full. If that drive wore pants, the seams would have split. The normal space hoggers were not at fault, as we attempted a manual disk cleanup. Checking the installed programs list, we find it is fully crammed with games. He must have downloaded an entire arcade of PC games, sports games of every genre, football games, fishing games, Deer Hunter. The list of games was pretty impressive, as we all knew how much they cost. We need to remove all of the unapproved applications, games, from your laptop because they have filled up the hard drive.
But I need all of those applications, games, for when I'm sitting at the airport.
We will be removing them because they are not approved and they are filling up the hard drive, which is affecting all of your apps.
But I only need you to fix my email. I don't have a problem with my hard drive.
You do have an issue with the hard drive. It is so full that it is failing when it tries to save the draft of the email you are trying to write.
You're just making that up. I'm talking to the VP because you're just telling me that to cover your incompetence. I have certificates for Microsoft and I know more about it than you do, and I just need you to fix my email.
Delete the unapproved apps, then fix the email. Magically, email works fine after freeing up disk space. We successfully update everything he hadn't updated for months and hand it back to him.
You were just using the games as an excuse to put the blame on me because you couldn't figure out the issue with my email quick enough. You must have just found a patch or rebuilt my profile or something. I'm going to talk with my Microsoft buddies to figure out what my issue really was. It can't possibly be related to the hard drive being full.
Microsoft buddies, your hard drive was full. So yes, Mr. Certified Deer Hunter, it is related, and we have issues with you on so many levels. I feel like a lot of people that carry certifications have a ginormous ego that follows because they feel that just because they're certified, they can do no wrong. This is a prime example. They thought they knew everything. Well, if they knew everything, you would think that they would have been able to fix their issue themselves. Our next tale is by Traveler1212, titled, Why Your PSU is Failing Within Your Warranty Period. I used to be working for a large Chinese manufacturer of computer cases and PSUs in Europe. When I received several complaints that the brand new PSU is not starting anymore, I started questioning our customers about their setup, pointing out that it could be that when the customer added more hardware, the PSU could not provide sufficient power and would fail the boot power. Initially, we just accepted the return and sending a brand new equal PSU. But after testing the PSUs afterwards, we found that over 95% of the returned PSUs could boot a fully functioning rig, meaning heavy-duty graphics card, several HDs, SSDs, even a digital currency mining rig, in case of a PSU with greater than 1000 watt power. So I started a questionnaire which we send out to customers which they needed to fill in and return to us before we would grant them an RMA. All the customers had one thing in common. All those who had failed PSUs within the warranty period used with new ASUS boards specific for overclocking digitally. Now, I am not an electrical engineer, but I think that the strict boot timing on those boards will cause the boot time to fail with the aging PSUs of this Chinese brand. PSUs, as far as I know, are still mainly analog devices. So the older they get, the slower response they give to the boot sequence. Hence the ASUS board will tell that the boot sequence, which has a response time limit, failed and won't start up. Many customers then tried a brand new PSU from us or other vendors straight from the box, and see it works, so it is our fault, the PSU is not working. After we started refusing the return on the fake failing PSUs and telling the customers to try the failing PSU with another motherboard manufacturer, which do not have digitally set a boot response time, we received positive feedback that the PSU indeed still worked. I sent a message to the general manager about my findings with the suggestion that they should change the way the PSU is built or contact ASUS about their boot timing. Never heard anything back from them, management that is. Since the customer needs to pay for the return of the PSU to us from anywhere in Europe, and the manufacturer pays the shipping fees to the customer, my investigation saved the customer and us the sending fees. Because we receive a PSU, it will be checked if the complaint is correct. If not, and after a day of testing with benchmarks, the PSU is working, we will send the PSU back because no fault could be discovered. With the upfront questionnaire, we could already suggest steps the customer could perform to see if it really is the PSU or if other equipment was at fault. I think it's crazy that there's a conflict between the PSU and ASUS boards, however, I'm not a techie in terms of knowing everything there is to know about computers, so that very well probably is a thing. The fact that you came up with the questionnaire though, that takes initiative and shows that you were really trying to get to the root of the problem. Kudos to you for that. And our final tale is from Mad Clarinet, titled Random Crashes, A Friend's Computer. A few years ago, a friend asked if I could have a look at his computer next time we visited. I'm okay with this. A lot of my friends are not exactly computer savvy and they know I work in IT. I haven't had anyone overdo it and want me to fix everything now, so it works well. One of my sisters and her family may be the subject of another post sometime. So, next time my wife and I are visiting, we're in the Bay Area, friend in Sacramento, I take a look. Computer is not exactly a fast one. All he does is internet, email, etc. He's a console gamer. He mentions a mutual friend looked at it a while ago and fixed an issue. Mutual friend is decent with IT and no idiot. Not an IT person, but trustworthy, and knows when to stop and ask someone like me. So I start the basics. Nothing untoward AV updated and scanning and fine. Nothing weird installed. In all respects, an unremarkable thing. Then it just locks up. No indication, just complete lockup. Restart computer, everything fine. Nothing in event logs to note, except the computer started without shutting down. Happens a few more times. No set timing or program issue. Nothing. So I suspect something hardware and start to pull the computer out to take the case off. Only thing that I note is that the VGA is connected to the onboard video card, not the installed graphics card. I usually have a small toolkit in my car, so it's not an issue of finding a screwdriver, etc. Plus, I usually have a multi-tool with me most of the time. Open the case, nothing bad. A bit of dust, but not that bad, even for someone who has a cat. Memory good, processor good, heatsink attached well, fans slightly dusty, but not anywhere near to cause an overheat. I pull out the graphics card and place it aside and check for bent pins or anything on the motherboard. Nothing. Not even a small hairline crack on a motherboard that was the problem I found on a computer years before, I think 1998-ish. I pick up the graphics card and realize what the problem is. There are 5 exploded capacitors on the graphics card. I put the computer back together and it now doesn't randomly crash anymore. My friend mentions that our mutual friend had looked at a graphics issue when they were visiting a few months before and moved the connection to the other VGA connector. I agree, that would be a fix, but I think he's missing telling me something. So I make a mental note to ask him next time we see him. Next time I see our mutual friend, I talk to him about it. He had his usual, really, he didn't do what we told him to do. They didn't open the computer, but told him to get the card replaced or looked at as soon as possible. Of course, the card wasn't replaced and hence the random crashes, which weren't occurring at the time they were there. Now, for the record, our mutual friend is good. No blame on him. Our other friend does have a habit of forgetting to get this fixed. Luckily, no harm done and we had a laugh at our friend's expense, and I have a fun story. Picture of the card. I completely get changing where you're plugging in onto the computer to get video is a temporary fix, but yeah, if your capacitors like that are exploded, even if one is like that, you should really replace your card, and that should alleviate most issues in terms of crashing due to graphics. Alright, that's enough tales for the day. Well, that wraps up this episode of Tales from Tech Support. If you liked the video, please drop a like, share my content on all of your social media, subscribe if you haven't already, and make sure to hit that bell so you're notified every time I upload, and drop a comment down below. Thanks for watching, thanks to my patrons, have a great day and stay safe out there.